closes in, shoots it, and hits Cook. Second power play unit on for the Penguins, trying to make it happen. Now Colin White, stall wouldn't let him
get in the face, Nagy, with, yep. I think with the puck. I think it was with the puck as he got his stick and deflow, and he's really hurting.
Darn. Lots of blood coming out of that.
That's a lot of blood.
Whatever's cut, his nose or whatever, but I'll tell you what. You hate to see that.
Well, it was Colin White to trying to clear that puck, and I don't know if it was his stick that followed through or it was the puck that went off Jordan Staal's stick and into his face. And there's a lot of blood on the ice. And Jordan Staal's going off very slowly here with the help with Chris Stewart. Jordan Staal, there goes his stick. And it goes off the puck and right into his face.
Hartman bracing for contact, and he unloaded on a checker who was, I think that's Krueger, and he can't get up.
Yeah, that was a reverse hit. That was a reverse
hit
sir. By Hartman.
Oh, and Krueger got lit up. He's bleeding. And now the play has been stopped. Marcus Krueger, and Hartman felt him coming, braced for contact, and as Eddie perfectly described it, a reverse hit.
There's Hartman. He takes a look. Here comes Krueger. Oh, and he just runs right into his elbow there, Pat. Hartman backed into him. He was anticipating the collision. See him how he's backing up, and then the elbow right in the face.
Penguins, he came after Kasparaitis. Trying to decapitate him, and they jump Kasparaitis. Here is a battle between Hicks and one of the Hurricanes. That's Emerson. Roberts comes over, and Hicks surveys the scene and now lets Emerson get up. And Roberts coming after Hicks. But Primo's the guy that went back after. Oh, Emerson is just thrashed. Hicks nailed him. Gasparaitis put a hit on Gary Roberts, and then Emerson, after the goal was scored,
they're going to be much more sensitive to any hits that he takes. Well, Gasparaitis really ran him from behind and just over along the near board. Nelson Emerson. Well, the fans in North Carolina might get an early taste of what this can be like sometimes. And there's Hicks. He just fired that right hand in on Emerson, and there's another one. Man, he's just running for cover now.
He knew he was hurt. So Roberts then came over.
He scores a goal and...
Acted wide by Wood. Domestikov getting to it. He is checked by Wood. And Wood challenged here by Schuster after that hit from behind. Wood firing right hands at Schuster. Domestikov trying to recover. He's on one knee and Schuster...
Schuster's injured too. He got that first punch right in the face. Wood really connected on that, but a bad hit on Nemestikov from behind, who's up on his feet, thank goodness. But the numbers were showing, the name was showing.
It's just a war zone down in front of Ford. Down goes one of the Sharks, and staying down. Is that Pavelski?
Oh, my. That's Pavelski. He's bleeding.
And the referees are talking right now. This is one of those things. This could be a five-minute major. Here, they got him.
The Sharks captain being attended to by head athletic trainer Ray Tufts.
They got Eakin. Here we go. It's going to be maybe four.
For now, it's four as Eakin's sent to the box. Debris starts to come out of the crowd as Cody Eakin sits for now, but he might get a major penalty and could be out of this game. But of more concern right now is Captain Joe Pavelski.
The draw right there. He creates cross check, and then a double whammy as his head hits off the ice.
Okay, keep an eye on Pavelski. He falls. You're right. On the side of his head.
And Cody Eakin's out of the game.
That's a, they pushed him right there, knocked Pavelski off.
Obviously with a head injury, is being helped off the ice to the Sharks dressing room, and not something you like to see.
Like, that tells you how much these guys care about each other. Thornton's right there holding the towel to the side of his head.
Former Los Angeles King to Letowski. You try to go back to the Lange, and now Letowski is hit here. He's out cold. He is. You're right, Bob. Who did he collide with? Oh, that is scary there. Oh, geez.
Matuski just had a great opportunity, had a chance to get into the, boy, Steggy, he may have hit his face on the ice. I believe there's some blood down there, and this is not good. Colby Armstrong collided with Letowski right in the high slot in the Pittsburgh zone.
Scary. They're calling for more help here, too, for Trevor Letowski.
Well, there, just in the left side of your picture, you saw Armstrong come in at the end and caught him right under the chin.
Very similar to the hit he put on player the other night. And
boy, that's scary right there. Letowski had no idea that Armstrong was coming late.
No, he didn't.
Oh, boy.
This is very scary. Very, very scary. Well, Colby came across and blindsided him after he made the pass.
Boy, they need some help out there. They need more help out here.
I think you're right, Bob.
Protects it up the near wall and reverses it back down low for Dupuis. Dupuis, Garrett Crosby. Sutton just hammers Dupuis into the end board.
I think he's out. I think he's out. He's bloody. He's got his... Oh, boy, this is not good. He's out. He's knocked out, Steggy. And you see the blood on the ice.
Sutton just plastered him into the end boards. Sutton down. He's concerned, too.
Everybody's concerned on the ice.
Oh.
Oh. Just a face right into the edge of the boards.
That's
reminds me of like a little bit of what when Chris Draper's face hit the edge of the board. Certainly a vulnerable position there for Dupuis, who's trying to protect the puck and turns his back to Sutton, and he's about 3 feet off the wall. And Sutton's been kicked out of this hockey game.
So much of it now in the game. Players' numbers are staring them right in the face, and yet they still hit guys into the boards from behind.
Nick Holden coming off the bench. Left it in the corner, and it's turned over. Now Armia trying to clear it. It came up and hit Stastny in the face. And Stastny is down, and he is bleeding.
That's a good call from the referee. He had a good view of it, and that hit him hard. And you blow it down right away. He's picking up his teeth. Yeah, that caught him right in the mouth. I agree with that call 100%. Get it down quickly and help him. It's 200 and something feet from the other end. And Armia has come over to say sorry.
Get the Hawks in a change. Haskinen. Good save by Ward. Haskinen put it in front. Picked off. Now we have a Hawks player, Murphy, shaken up. The whistle goes, and Mike Gatsby's going to scurry off the bench again. Connor Murphy, you can see, has been opened up. So Mike Gatsby getting assistance from the captain to get out and tend to his injured defenseman. So Cam Ward, huge here in the late stages, as he's been all night.
Well, Connor Murphy was coming over here, Pat. And he gets picked by Pitlick. And he catches an elbow. And went right down.
Connor Murphy, you see, will head off for some repairs with the medical trainer, Mike Gatsky. We have 3 minutes to go in regulation here.
I mean, there's the change, and all of a sudden, here comes
later, dudes.
Dallas. And then there you see the elbow. I mean, no chance for him to protect himself.